Does your property management company collect security deposits from both tenants and landlords? Well, then you should watch this video, Collecting Security Deposits. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Let's imagine that we have a new policy. Security deposits will be collected from all as of March 1. Landlords must give $2,000 each and tenants give $1,000 each for their deposits respectfully. Now let's imagine on March 1 we receive $2,000 from Alan the landlord for his operating deposit, and that will be deposited into our operating account and not a special bank account. So what will be the result in the trial balance if we record $2,000 more in our operating account because of the landlord operating deposit that we received from Alan? Well, our bank account, well, landlord operating deposit will show up for the first time as a $2,000 credit balance liability owed back to Alan until it is applied or given back. And because our bank account has $2,000 more, it will increase to $4,800. Let's take a look at how to record it. Now, this is the way the trial balance looks before we record the tenant's security, the landlord's security deposit, Alan the landlord. We click payment because we received a payment from Alan. And we choose only Alan, not one of his tenants, only Alan. Now, we ignore all these other things down here. We just put the 2000, push tab. But the most important one is this. Notice there's a new field in this window called the AR account field. And once you have more than one accounts receivable type of account in your file, this pull-down menu choice will appear in the customer payment window so you can choose which account you are receiving the payment from or into. And in this case, it will be landlord operating deposit, the specific accounts receivable type of account that we're collecting money for is this landlord operating deposit. That's it. And now when we click save and close here at the, you can't see the bottom of the window, but there's a little save and close right there. Boom. Just click OK in the middle. And now you can see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. The operating deposit for landlords showed up for the first time as 2000. And our bank account shows a balance of $4,800, where $2,000 should be reserved to give back any landlord client deposit if they quit and leave us. Now, what about the next transaction? Received another $2,000 from another landlord client, Dave, for his operating deposit. And let's take a look at what the results will be. Well, if we receive $2,000 more, well, the landlord operating deposit will increase by $2,000 because we owe $2,000 more to another landlord client, Dave. And if the money went into the Chase bank account, that will increase by $2,000 and become $6,800. That means that of the $6,800 in the operating account, $4,000 should be reserved to be able to pay back a landlord's deposit if they leave us. So let's record this the exact same way and see the trial balance looks the way it looks before we record our first security deposit. We click payment because we received a payment. And we choose Alan Arby, not one of his tenants. And we put the date that we physically received it In our example, it's March 1 of 2022. The money's going into this bank account, our operating bank account, cash in Chase Bank. But the most important thing to notice is here. There's a new pull-down menu choice right here, and the reason this suddenly appeared is because we now have more than one accounts receivable type of account in our QuickBooks file. So as soon as we have an additional accounts receivable type, we can choose in this window which account receivable account to record the payment. And in this case, it's landlord operating deposit. Landlord operating deposit is the reason we are collecting, and the money's going into Chase Bank, and it's from Allen on March 1, $2,000. When we click save and close at the bottom of the window, just click OK, and you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. Cash in Chase Bank increased by $2,000 and became $4,800. And landlord operating deposit shows $2,000 that we owe as a credit balance if they quit and leave us tomorrow. But more importantly, look at this report. Landlord security deposit shows specifically Alan, who gave us this payment on March 1, and that's the reason the 2,000 here equals the 2,000 there. But let's watch what happens when we record receiving another security deposit. Let's imagine that we also on March 1 received $2,000 from Dave for his operating deposit. So what will be the result in the trial balance? Well, the landlord operating deposit, we just got 2,000 more, so that should increase by 2,000 and become 4,000. And if the money goes into the Chase operating account, that will increase by 2,000 and become 6,800. And of the 6,800 in the operating account, 4,000 should be reserved for paying back landlords who quit and want to get their deposit back. But it's very easy. We'll record it the same way. We click payment, QuickBooks remembers the date, and all we have to do is choose the landlord, not one of his tenants, just the landlord. The money's going into cash in Chase Bank, but you must choose every time you're in the receive payment window, you must be careful to choose the proper receivables account, in this case landlord operating deposit, and we put 2,000 push tab. Now all we have to do is click save and close at the bottom of the window. See if we can squash this down a little. Nope, maybe. Okay, boom, click OK, and now the results are exactly as what we predicted. Landlord operating deposit is 4,000 and cash in Chase Bank is 6,800. And if you ask why is the landlord operating deposit 4,000, the answer to that question is in the landlord's security deposit report. You can see that the reason we owe 4,000 is because we received a security deposit of 2,000 from Alan. We received a security deposit of 2,000 from Dave, and that's why the total landlord security deposit is equal to $4,000. Now let's record receiving the tenant's deposit. Let's imagine on March 1, we received $1,000 from Betty Boop for her security deposit. So what will happen in the trial balance if we receive $1,000 for a tenant's security deposit? Well, we designated a specific bank account called Tenants Cash Deposit. And this is the first deposit into this special bank account for $1,000. And of course, if Betty suddenly moves, we owe her the money back. So we have this liability account tenant security deposit, which also shows up for $1,000. Now, of course, this might not be the order of the accounts. These accounts will show up a little higher up on the list, but these will be the names and numbers that show up after we record the tenant security deposit from Betty. Same thing, payment, and then we click Betty Boop, March 1. Don't forget, the most important part of this window is choosing the proper accounts receivable account. Betty is a tenant. We are receiving the tenant's security deposit. And be very, very careful. The money is going into this bank account, tenant cash deposit. So it's going into tenant cash deposit and tenant security, March 1, $1,000. Now, when we click save and close, click OK, the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Tenant's cash deposit showed up for $1,000, and tenant's security deposit showed up for $1,000. This is the trust account. This is the liability account that represents what we owe. So, also on March 1, we received $1,000 from Candy for her security deposit. So what now will be the result in the trial balance? Well, the tenant security deposit will increase. Well, the tenant cash deposit will increase to $2,000 from $1,000 up here, because this bank account will physically have $1,000 more, and the liability, what we owe back to tenants if they move out, that will also increase by $1,000, and this will be the result in the trial balance after recording Candy's security deposit. So, we click payment, we choose the proper tenant, Candy Charles, QuickBooks remembers the date. Most important, the money is being physically deposited into the tenant cash deposit bank account, and the proper accounts receivable account that represents the current liability that we owe back to tenants if they move is tenant security deposit. And then we record $1,000, and of course, all you have to do is do save and close, click OK, and the results are exactly as what we expected. We now have physically $2,000 in this trust account that represents the money we have in the special bank account to give back security deposits, but we also have this $2,000 liability. Now, if you ask, why is tenant security deposits a total of $2,000? The answer to that question is in this report, Tenants Security Deposit. We click and you can see the reason why this number is 2,000 is because we owe 1,000 to Betty if she moves out tomorrow. We owe another 1,000 to Candy if she moves out tomorrow. And that's why the total 2,000 is equal to the 2,000 in the trial balance for the security deposit to tenants. And now it's your turn. See if you can record all the security deposits from both of Dave Deeney's tenants, Eddie Edwards and Freddie Froda. We received $1,000 from each of them on March 1 for their tenant security deposit. Try to do it by repeating what you saw just now in this video. When you finish, your trial balance should look like this. If it does not, then you need to go back and find and fix mistakes the way we learned in prior videos. Also, when you finish, your tenant security deposit report should look like this. And again, if it doesn't, you have to go back and find and fix mistakes the way that we learned. You can rewind the video and pause the video to compare it to your own reports to see if you were successful. One last note. Landlord payout balances report must not have any security deposit transaction at all. If it does, then you must redo the last part of the prior video. We fixed this report so that it would not show up. Only rent payable to landlords would be transactions that would be listed in this report. No security deposit transactions. You see, this account clearly says tenant security deposit. This one, if you stretch it out a bit, says landlord operating deposit, and this report should only be managing the normal rent. If not, then do what you learn to find and fix.